Activate ruler by clicking ruler checkbox on view tab. Now click layout tab and margins button. Now click custom margin and set all margin values to 0. Click OK button and ignore the warning. Click layout tab again and change page size to A4 if not already selected. This color palette contains 4 colors with their respective RGB values. We're going to need those colors in this tutorial. Now click Insert tab and click Shapes button. Now select this shape and draw it on the page. You can make it more round by simply dragging this yellow dot. Now change its color to light gray that you saw on the color palette, which has RGB value of 65, 65 and 67. Click Format tab and click Shape Fill. Now click More Fill Color and change both red and green values to 65 and blue will be 67. 65, 65 and 67, click OK. By using RGB values, now we have the exact same color as you saw on the color palette. Also, it has a very thin outline which we need to remove. Select it, click Format tab and click Shape Outline. Now select No Outline. Click Insert tab, click Shapes button and select this rectangle. Draw it over here and change its color to light blue, which has color code of 1, 125 and 197. From the Format tab, click Shape Fill button. Now click More Fill Colors and change red value to 1. Green will be 125 and blue is 197. Click OK. Now let's remove the outline by clicking Shape Outline and No Outline. Place it over here. Now draw another rectangle like this. Change its outline to No Outline and place it like this. Change its fill color to white. And now just resize it. If you want to move any shape, just select it and use left, right and up down arrow keys from the keyboard. Moving objects with keyboard arrows is more accurate than using mouse pointer. Click Insert, click Shapes and select this basic shape. Draw it on the page and click Shape Fill. Now click More Fill Color. Let's open the color palette. We are going to use the second blue color, which has RGB value of 0, 102 and 174. So write 0 in red, green will be 102 and blue will be 174. Click OK after verifying the color codes. Now move it over here. Resize it. Also, you can change its angle by dragging this yellow dot like this. Now we need to remove the outline. Select it and click Shape Outline and No Outline. To duplicate any object, hold the Ctrl key while dragging it, or you can press Ctrl plus D after selecting. This is the color code that we will use. Select it, click Format tab, click Shape Fill and More Fill Color. Now change red value to 1, green will be 84 and blue will be 162. 84 and 162. Now click OK after verifying the RGB values. Now I am going to place it over the previous shape. Also, we need to make some small adjustments. After adjusting, hold the Ctrl key and select every shape by clicking on them. Right click on the selected shapes, click Group. Again, click on Group. Now we got a group of shapes, but still we can select individual shapes from the group by double clicking on them. Let's make some adjustments. Now we need to make a second copy of this group. For that, hold the Ctrl key while dragging it, or just press Ctrl plus D after selecting it. Select the second group of shapes, click Format tab, click Rotate button. Now we need to rotate this shape 180 degree. For that, we are going to select Rotate right 90 degree twice. Now move it to the bottom of the page. Like this. Click Insert, click Text Box, and click Draw Text Box. Draw a small text box over here and type your company name. Make the text little larger and adjust the text box. Now remove the outline. Also remove fill color by clicking Shape Fill and No Fill. Click Insert, click Picture, and select the logo of your company. Click Insert. The logo came behind those shapes. Click Wrap Text and select In Front of Text. This will bring the logo in front of everything else. Now resize the logo and place it over the company name. Instead of creating another text box, you can duplicate the company name text box by holding Ctrl key while dragging it, or you can press Ctrl plus D after selecting. Now change the text to headline. This will be your original headline. Now select the headline and change its font size to 36. Also change its color by clicking this arrow, click More Color and Custom Color. Now let's open the color palette and use this light gray color. For that, type 65 for red, 65 for green, and blue will be 67. Click OK or press Enter. Now duplicate it by holding Ctrl key, or you can press Ctrl plus D as I said before. Resize it. Now select the text, change the font size to 16. And change the font to Calibri Light. This is a light font. In my case, I am using rand function to create some random text, but you need to write your own text over here. After that, select the text and choose justify alignment. Now duplicate the headline text box by holding Ctrl and remove the text. Now change its size and write your second headline over here. Make it a little bit smaller. Now duplicate this one and place it over here. Now remove this second paragraph from it. Resize it. And adjust the other text box if you need to. Now duplicate this text box and place it here. We will put our signature over here. In my case, I am using picture of a signature, but it will be more authentic if you sign it. So you can always leave this space blank, but I'm going to insert pictures and select the signature and click insert. The signature came behind some other shapes, so click text warp or warp text, click in front of text and place it in between. Now let's add company web address or website name. Duplicate a text box, place it over here and select the texts. Change the text color to white. Type your website address and make it little bit smaller. Align it properly. Duplicate another text box to write contact number. Select it and change the font to Calibri Light and type your phone number. Select it and remove the space after paragraph. Also change the line spacing value to 1.0. Now duplicate this text box and type your email address. If you press enter, you will get a blue underline which you can remove by pressing Ctrl plus Z or undo. Type your website, also press Ctrl plus Z to remove the blue underline. Duplicate this text box again and type your company address. Let's add the symbols. For that, click insert, click pictures and select the phone symbol and click insert. This time also you need to change the text warping to front of text and place the logo right here. Click insert again, click pictures and select the internet logo. Click insert and change the text warping to in front of text. Place it in front of email ID and web address. Now click insert again, then click pictures and select the direction logo. Click insert and click warp text. Select in front of text as text warping and place your direction logo in front of the address. Adjust the text boxes if you want to. Also remember, all the project files including this letterhead we are creating is available for download in the video description. You can use those files to create your own version of letterhead. Click File, click Save As, click Browse and choose the location if you want to save your file in. Save your file as PDF if you want to print it. And if you want your file to be editable in the future, please save it in docx format. For printing, use PDF. And this is the final design in PDF format. Please like this video if you like it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.